For centuries, religions around the world have said a lot about belief and death. If you observe closely, you will find most religions either believe in reincarnation or a more permanent settlement in hell or heaven. An average man believing in science can be confused thinking who has the actual secrets of death or afterlife. Is it the old scriptures like Indian Vedas and Garud Puran, or modern scientific research? Through various mediums, you have heard a lot about death. So we are not here to discuss what Mayans or Egyptians thought about death. Rather, we will be looking at the most important set of rare, unknown information every human should know before death. In the last decade, humans have enhanced the technologies which can help prolong life. This includes genome sequencing for developing customized medicines, organ 3D printing for developing synthetic organs like heart or kidneys, and even AI systems that do in-depth monitoring and analysis to find emerging threats which can be nipped in the bud if steps are taken in the golden hours. We all know what we should do with our life and have plans for the time we have. Though it may sound bizarre to think about what steps we should take to manage our after-death experience, but it is very important for 21st century man to weigh the various possibilities given by science. So let's check out those 5 things which can help you make better decisions for posthumous management.
We have tried to perform a digital transformation process with almost every single thing we can see, right from self-managed toilets to edible biodegradable chips. Those funky multicolor LED lights and sharp display units are seen everywhere now. They exist on your cars, on your clothes, and even your water bottles. But who should think about digitalizing something that goes as the last asset for any human? Yes, we are talking about coffins of the future. A UK-based company, Perfect Choice Funeral Plans, have come up with a digital mock-up of tomorrow's coffin, which may amaze few like me, but can also evoke anger for many others. As you see, these smart coffins have a large digital display which shows the photos of the deceased, videos and illustrations paying homage in a futuristic style. This includes social media integration, which can load up all the comments people are making about the deceased. These comments are extracted from the deceased Instagram and Twitter accounts. These cool cabinets are also equipped with a speaker. Of course, not for the entertainment of the soul. However, if funeral attendees are struggling to speak, an audio version of eulogy can be played. Progeny of humanity may witness a few hundred-year-old Russians taking part in TEDx shows, sharing their experiences of artificial reincarnation, or what they also call a second life. If you think it's a joke, visit Cryorus Cryonic Center in Moscow. There, you can book a service allowing them to take your dead body and retain it so it stays fresh enough to be repaired and rejuvenated in the future. All the while, waiting for medical science to advance. Sounds creepy? But it comes with a ray of hope for anyone who doesn't want to make a permanent exit from this circus called the world. And I think it's also for those who don't like the flashy LED lighting and speakers on their coffin. Cryogenic freezing is a technological service for future mankind. This is how it works. Once a doctor declares you dead, a medical team from the cryonic center will reach to the hospital. They will then cool your dead body with ice water and also use a computerized CPR system and oxygen mask to keep your tissues oxygenated. The ice-cold body is then shifted into a hermetic container. You can also call it an air-sealed container, which is then shipped to a cryonics facility. Here, more advanced pumping machines are connected to keep the blood circulation going at a certain rate. The body is then finally locked inside a nitrogen liquid vapor capsule with a temperature maintained at minus 195 degrees Celsius for perpetuity. These are the top companies in the world that can give you an ambulance ride to future hospitals. I'm quoting Dennis Kowalski, who is the president of the Cryonics Institute and an evangelist in the United States. The cost is around $28,000 per person to be their guest. Not sure if there are any discounts or family packages available yet. What we know of ourselves is more than just matter. The entire scriptures of Hinduism and Jainism include many more deeply believing in a non-matter element that represents your consciousness or what you call self. But we have a consortium of scientists worldwide who believe that perfect brain scanning and mapping will allow them to recreate a digital version of a human brain with long-term memory and the self intact. They call this process as whole brain emulation, which is also termed as mind uploading. Carbon Copies is a non-profit organization that supports scientists around the world ready to work on the challenges they face building the perfect mind uploading system. In 2019, a set of scientists were able to create a WBE model of a cubic millimeter portion of a mouse brain. It had 100,000 neurons and 4 kilometers of nerve fiber, all inside something the size of a large sand speck. But even with this small size and comparatively less complex brain, months were required just to map every single cell. Every biological structure of network sub-organs was broken down and scanned. This was tasked into 25,000 slices of the mouse brain. The total amount of storage required to store and process all the scanned images was a whopping 2 million gigabytes. With simple math, they predicted that a similar process for an entire human brain would require the data storage space of more than 2 million petabytes. That is more than the total available storage space in all the data centers around the world. So, if any of these projects ever get successful, a majority of the work will be completed towards an actual cyborg. This digital brain, which is a whole brain emulation of a human, can be transferred into a humanoid robot, making the human alive again, but with a metal body and electronic sensors. At the very least, this emulation model can be run in a computer software system just to keep the communications ongoing with the mind of the deceased. If you are happy with your life and have a true sense of satisfaction in allowing yourself to go back to nature, then this one is for you. I can say if the spiritual gurus come across this option, many would love to opt in. We always talk about the raging and growing bulk of aggressive technologies eager to break the rules of life and for some, the rules of God, depending on the culture. Different belief systems have different ways of removing and honoring dead bodies. And this one might catch eyes of many nature lovers around the world. Project Capsula Mundi is a developed biodegradable urn which can be buried underground, allowing a tree to be grown on top. This changes the look of old boring graveyards into nicely managed forests and allows relatives of the deceased to take care of a memorial tree. The body will provide nutrition to the tree and a lifelong contribution to the soil. It's a great way to help in global warming, as more trees will be planted and will also stop tree cutting meant for making coffins. The urn is an egg-shaped coffin where dead body is carefully placed in a fetal position, just like a baby in womb. The person registered for this service can select the tree of his choice. Death brings a stop to everything related to our existence. Sudden deaths can change market status or allow evil to play rogue games, hampering destiny. So is there a way where we can bring a dead CEO back to the meeting room as a holograph, giving advice or instruction after death? The answer to this question lies with a few companies who are trying to partially or fully create digital avatars which are run by AI systems in the backend. This AI system is powered by all the data collected about the deceased human: videos, images, speeches, documents, online behavior, and many other pieces of data collected. That data, collected over years, is translated into deep learning models that stand as a digital twin of a human being. Many celebrities are excited to get digital embalming so that digital avatars can work in films and productions even after death. A startup company, Nectom, which is funded by Y Combinator, is coming up with a service to perform digital embalming of your brain. The only thing creepy here is the fact that you can go for this process only after death. Currently, they are not giving any guarantee of successful transfer of consciousness, and the process may fail. So, these are the 5 options you should know before dying. You may opt for one or more, depending on your belief and financial status. With all this coming up, one thing is sure: we are going to get rid of many existing problems and, at the same time, give birth to a plethora of unknown challenges. Which one do you think is suitable for you? Do you want to become just a tree? Or plan to take a cyborg form and visit your grandson's 50th work anniversary? Let me know in the comments. Till then, stay tuned with Robocial.